You say these are progressively going to get more difficult? Okay, that one was pretty easy. Hey, it's Black Thought, and you're watching Reverse the Verse. Okay, I've got 10 seconds to listen to my song backwards, and I have to guess what it is. No gold teeth. I can tell by the cymbal sounds in the drum. The original idea for that song is over 10 years old. But what it evolved into is just something completely different lyrically, and you know, the beat has been changed. So yeah, it took some time for us to sort of, you know, come back around to a serious endeavor. You can stop it. I didn't think I was gonna be able to, you know, to guess these, but it's pretty easy. Like, that is that's what they do. Shooting the video for that here in Times Square, that was all huge for us at that point in our career. It caused so many different cliches. You know, music video, hip hop music video cliches out. Just being a huge fan of Tony and Rafael Sadiq at the time, and you know, that's sort of how, you know, we got to know him, was through that relationship. And we worked on, you know, the initial idea, and we took the song to San Francisco to get with his brother Dwayne and like the rest of the Tony guys. Spanky, who was a brilliant guitarist, who was really made that record his own. Just yeah, an awesome experience. That would be a Good Morning. I got Pusha and Killer Mike on it. It was produced by Sean C. This was just, you know, lent his vocal to it. Pusha and I, we have a pretty good relationship. We always have. We did some extensive touring with Pharrell during the time when Pharrell was sort of taking the clips everywhere he went. So, you know, we grew up together essentially, but I haven't seen him in quite some time. But Sean C has a working relationship with him, and he got the verse from him. And then Mike's verse came from his and my relationship. I thought these were supposed to get more difficult. That You Got Me, you know, featuring Erykah Badu, and also featuring Eve. The chorus was written by Jill Scott, and the beat was produced by Scott Storch. He just played like, you know, a rough, loose, super loose idea. That was one of those songs that I knew at first sight. I mean, it just represents an evolution. We started The Roots in like 1987. We somehow kept the band together. Once neither of us was in school anymore, we decided to start playing on the street, South Street, Passyunk Avenue in Philly. That's how we were gonna make the decision of, do we stay together as a band, or do we sort of, you know, go our separate ways and live our lives? And the people spoke, and they were like, yo, we want The Roots right now. All these records sound the same backwards. The Seed 2.0 featuring The Roots, as it was, you know, it was Cody's record. At the time, you know, we're working with Cody Chestnut. I want to say in the early aughts. I mean, he had an album called The Headphone Masterpiece that was, you know, a timeless classic. I think it is today. And when the idea presented itself to sort of tamper with perfection, I was scared to death because I felt like, you know, why? So yeah, it took some time. I think we were in Electric Lady Studios. I remember Yasiin Bey was there, like, you know, playing some stuff on the piano. Random friends of ours were sort of in the place, and their energy definitely contributed to where we arrived, you know what I'm saying? Like when we sort of wound up with the song. That is Strangers featuring ASAP Rocky, Run the Jewels. A beat that Danger Mouse had given me sort of early on. I think the first thing I did on it wasn't what we needed. I think I was rapping in a tone probably closer to my speaking voice. You know, but sometimes you have to extend yourself beyond your sweet spot, sort of do something different vocally as the song calls for. And that was one of those records that it just called for a different energy. A$AP Rocky's a good friend of mine. My fellow Libra, he and I share a birthday. But he just has a really good relationship with Danger Mouse, because Danger Mouse and did some production for him, long last A$AP album, which in my opinion, that's my favorite A$AP Rocky album. We had A$AP's feature almost immediately, you know, and then it took some time just scheduling wise to get the verse from Run the Jewels. And then plus, you know, this is my second album in a row sort of, you know, hit calling Killer Mike. So he probably is like, come on, man, this guy's, I might be becoming a pest. You know what I'm saying? The Black Thug calls me one more time, man, that's it. Yeah, man, get like me. What did I win? Hey, what's going on? This is Black Thought. You just watched Reverse the Verse. My new album with Danger Mouse and Black Thought, Cheat Codes, is out now. Make sure you grab that.